Hey guys, how are you? Welcome back. Today I thought I would sit down and show you lettering on Procreate Pocket. I got a few questions about it and I did do a post earlier last year that got a bunch of love, so I thought I would go through my technique and how I do this kind of lettering. I actually found this technique on TikTok of all places, of course, but I can't find the reference, but I'm sure you guys will have seen it online. It's really, really simple, and if you do want to get into some kind of lettering or try it out, this is a good place to start. So I am going to sit on my phone and go through a time-lapse video of my post, and I'll put it up on screen here. Anything I kind of want to run through with you, I will also switch over and show you how I draw that too. So before we begin, if you do like these kind of videos, anything design related, self-employment, a little bit of travel and fashion here and there, then please do subscribe. I would absolutely love that. And if you do want notifications whenever I upload, then hit the little bell down below as well. So let's get going. This is the post that I put on my Studio Sober Instagram. I uploaded it earlier last year when everyone was kind of shutting down and there was that full support your local business kind of forefront. And I created this little support NZ local design. Thought it was quite cool. So I'll show you how to run through that. And again, this can be like easily adapted to any kind of wording, any kind of shapes, colors, whatever you like. But the first thing that you need to do is create a shape. So I went with a circle. You could do a square, you could do a heart, you could do a triangle, but some kind of basic shape, because you've got to keep in mind, you've got to fit the words and kind of mesh them in with the shape. So don't do something too crazy, but yeah, I think a circle is a great place to begin with. So I'm actually going to switch screens and show you how I draw a circle on Procreate. Super easy. So guys, to draw a perfect circle, just make sure you've got your brush tool selected. And then go about drawing a freehand circle and hold down at the end and it will create a really nice curve. That is so terrible. That is literally an oval. But as you can see here, when I move my brush up and down, it makes the circle bigger and smaller. And it's also made that really nice curve as well. But it's not a perfect circle. So while holding down with your pen, then hold down with your finger on the screen and you can see it changes it to a perfect circle here. From oval to circle. So your brush is holding down. Now with your second finger, you can hold down and create a perfect circle and then just lift off with your brush and there you have a perfect circle. Okay, so now that we've drawn the circle, the next thing I did was create a straight line kind of in between, kind of centering that shape. Again, same as the circle, you just go from point A to point B and hold down at point B and your line will become straight. This can all be on the same layer because we will delete the layer. This is just all for guidance when you're drawing in the beginning. Once you have that done, you can then go to your layers, tap on the layer once with two fingers, and then you can change the opacity of this. This is actually really helpful for when you then go draw over the top because you can make the layer below lighter so it's not too, it doesn't interfere so much with what you're drawing over with. So as you can see here, I've kind of just done a very rough kind of bold text outline. You can go back and forth, kind of erase it, come back to it, scribble over it. It really doesn't matter. Again, this is just kind of like a guide draft for your letters. So now you can see I've kind of got a very rough block letter for that top word support. So now you fill it in because then it kind of gets things moving. To fill all the letters in, you do that same color drop. So you grab the black from the circle in the top right hand corner and drag it onto your letter. If the block letters are all connected, then it should fill your letter perfectly. So as you can see there, I have got support all filled in and then I move on to NZ. And then I move on to local. Again, pretty simple. You can go back and forth with the eraser. It's super easy because it's on a new layer. It doesn't take away from your layer underneath. That is your guide. So that's really helpful. And again, it is totally up to you how you draw this, how you fit all the letters in. But once you've filled them in, it does kind of give you a better idea that you can add some more corners on or erase bits off. And then the last letter that I had to do there was the Z. I had a little trouble with this letter. The next step I would say is to put a block color on the background. give it something bright, bold, whatever you like, and you can really see that shape of the circle stand out more through the letters that you've created. I put in this really like bold green aqua color just to really like mix it up. You can choose any color that you like. Then this next step that I like to do is I duplicate the layer that has the filled block letters on it. I just duplicate that a couple times and then you can color them different colors. I can show you how to do this on my phone too. Let's just fill this circle with a color black, but I want to duplicate this. So you go up to layers and then you swipe left and it gives you the option to lock, duplicate or delete. Don't delete it. Duplicate it, and there you can see you've got the same layer 7, but you've got another one. And what you're going to do is then change the color of this second layer, drop in the color, and you can go modify, transform, and you can see there's that black layer behind it. So that's how I created the kind of shadow effect with the filled in block letters. Same situation, just duplicate the layer, add a different color, and you get this really cool effect. So I think the first color I did was a green, like a very grass green, but it still worked well with that aqua background. I also made sure I had a white layer, and I also did this very, so bad at describing colors, gray blue ocean color. And as you can see here, by adjusting all the layers slightly, you can create this shadow effect in different colors, which I thought was very cool. So that's it, guys. It's honestly that easy. That's how I created this image. If you want to see more from me, head to my Instagram @StudioSobo and tag me if you recreate this kind of style of lettering on Procreate Pocket. Please do. I would love to see it. Or get in touch with me at www.studiosobo.com. I would love to chat. Also, I was thinking if you do want to dive into the whole typography realm of design, head to Creative Market. I'll link it down below. Great stuff. Honestly, it has elevated the way I do design, and they have the most amazing artists on there, all creating different kinds of fonts, packages, photos galore. You'll be inspired. Please check them out. That's it from me, guys. See you soon. Bye.